Mobile web browsers may scale down your web page. That may result in unattractive and unreadable content. They may also not show the full width of your page. This makes the user resize and horizontally scroll your page. Or worse, they might just hit the back button. So you may find the work that you put into designing your page becomes ineffective. So let's look at this problem and the simple HTML tag to correct it. As we moved into the age of browsing websites on devices like smartphones and tablets, we found that a lot of the websites were scaled down and partially shown off screen. And that even exists today with a lot of websites. Mobile browsers render pages in a virtual window called a viewport, and the web pages are usually wider than the screen, so they do not squeeze every page layout into a tiny window. In our case, we're trying to design for the actual screen width. So the first step is to make sure the devices are aware that we want our page initially rendered without any scaling and so that they fit within 100% of the actual screen width. This is our practice web page showing in an iPhone in portrait mode. And you can see that the default for the iPhone was to fit all the content within the screen, but also it scaled it down so that it's very tiny to see. And we could expand that by increasing the scaling with our gestures, but we really want to design a view that fits this screen and makes it easy for the user to read the content and access it without having to make adjustments in scaling. The mobile version of Safari introduced a virtual port meta tag. This allows the web developers to control the viewport size and scaling. And many other web browsers now support this tag, although it's really not part of any particular web standard. For the name attribute, you just simply set it equals to the keyword viewport. The content attribute is set equals to a comma delimited list of name value pairs. There are different properties. For example, we see width, initial scale. There's also user scalable. And these are pretty much up to the web browser companies to decide what they'd like to use in the actual list. So when you're designing for a particular device, such as an iPhone, you will really want to set the width to the width of the device. So in that case, we use the width property and we set it equals to device-width, and that handles that for us. And finally, you want to have the initial scale property set to 1 so that all the content is within the actual device screen, and we'll leave it up to the user if they want to zoom in on their own. Here you can compare our web page with and without the viewport meta tag. The one on the left doesn't have the viewport meta tag, and the one on the right has the one we entered in with the width set to the device width and the initial scale set to 1. The styling has not changed. The same CSS properties are in place: font sizes, margins, paddings, background colors. And because this is a simple one-column page layout, the only real difference we're seeing is that the paragraphs are wrapping a little sooner and pushing the content further down the page. For small device widths, you are likely to use single-column layouts and smaller size content. But your design alternatives increase as the width of devices increase. For example, you can use multiple column layouts and make larger content. To apply different layouts and styles, you will use CSS media queries to detect device widths. We are going to explore using media queries in this video series. In all cases, you use the media tag to set the viewport width and scaling.